And that was Aunt Philippa for you. For the next 3 weeks she was a blissfully excited, busy woman. I was allowed to choose the material and fashion of my wedding suit and hat myself, but almost everything else was settled by Aunt Philippa. I didn't mind. It was a relief to be rid of all responsibility. I did protest when she declared her intention of having a big wedding and asking all the cousins and semi-cousins on the island, but Aunt Philippa swept my objections lightly aside. "I'm bound to have one good wedding in this house," she said. "Not likely I'll ever have another chance." She found time amid all the baking and concocting to warn me frequently not to take it too much to heart if Mark failed to come after all. "I know a man who jilted a girl on her wedding day. That's the men for you. It's best to be prepared." But Mark did come, getting there the evening before our wedding day. And then a severe blow fell on Aunt Philippa. Word came from the manse that Mr. Bentwell had been suddenly summoned to Nova Scotia to his mother's deathbed. He had started that night. "That's the men for you," said Aunt Philippa bitterly. "Never can depend on one of them, not even on a minister. What's to be done now?"
"Get another minister," said Mark easily.
"Where'll you get him?" demanded Aunt Philippa. "The minister at Cliftonville is away on his vacation, and Mercer is vacant, and that leaves none nearer than town. It won't do to depend on a town minister being able to come. No, there's no help for it. You'll have to have that Methodist man." Aunt Philippa's tone was tragic. Plainly, she thought the ceremony would scarcely be legal if that Methodist man married us, but neither Mark nor I cared. We were too happy to be disturbed by any such trifles. The young Methodist minister married us the next day in the presence of many beaming guests. Aunt Philippa, splendid in black silk and point lace collar, neither of which lost a whit of dignity or luster by being made 10 years before, was composure itself while the ceremony was going on. But no sooner had the minister pronounced us man and wife than she spoke up.